declared war. We need your best hunters, preferably ones without children. This is gonna get bloody.
But what of our plan? To bring our people together, to
it's
persuade
too late for that, Mira. It's them or us now.
For decades, I teach my people peace. And now you would have us march to war?
Roma's research is what led me to Nushi. Now Nevik has it, and it's only a matter of time.
Your men, your Corona's crew, they'll fight alongside us, won't they?
Can't count on that. Maybe if I had time to explain who you are. But I've been lying to them so long. It's best we leave them out of it.
Suppose we succeed. They will call for reinforcements. Return with greater numbers.
Yes, that's why step one is the relay. As long as his cruiser is grounded on EDN-3, Eisenberg needs the satellite relay to broadcast off-planet. So we're gonna need to blow it up.
I can do that.
Once you turn against your masters, how do you expect to ever see your family again? You would strand yourself here.
We don't destroy the cruiser, we commandeer it. Once we break Nevek's grip, we give everyone a choice to stay or go.
And once you go, how long before Nevik returns again to look for their lost?
Before we destroy the relay, we'll hack it. Use it to send a message. An idea that should buy you another 50 years. The relay gambit doubles as a diversion. When Eisenberg sends troops to investigate, your forces will be ready to hijack the cruiser before they even think of returning it to orbit.
We will be ready.
Jim, I can handle the explosives, but I haven't a hacker skill.
On that part, we're gonna need a little help.
I am so in.
Really? But I haven't explained it.
I assumed it has something to do with the Snow Princess you've been hanging out with. It's cool. I saw her on your rig's video feed. I figured you'd explain it when the time was right. Jim, I know who I trust. I trust you. Say the word.
Gail Holden? You're a remarkable young man.
Nobody's ever called me a man before.
Probably because they thought you'd say that.
Is this it? Is it time to go? Is it literally go time? Because listen, man, there's no going back after this. You want to tie up any loose ends, maybe line up a few more upgrades, you better see to it before we get this party started.
It's time, Gail. Let's saddle up. I'll bring you up to speed on the way.
We're doing it.
So wait. This Nushi thing is where pure tea energy comes from, and it heals flesh, and it somehow helped the colonists survive for 40 years?
Kid, if we pull this off, we'll have time to review the details on the way back to Earth.
Right, because then you and I, we're gonna hijack Eisenberg's ship and, like, not die.
Look, one step at a time. First, we gotta make sure they can't call for backup, and make sure Nevik never wants to return to this planet. So you better be able to hack the relay.
I'm sure he's up for it.
Yeah! Where did she come from?
She's stealthy. You'll get used to it.
There were no adults available.
Hey, you should talk.
None as smart or as loyal. Just trust me, all right?
He'll be tested soon enough.
What'd you got there?
An abundance of C4.
Oh, that is so dope. Dude.
Hi, Gail. Nice to meet you. Welcome to Team Jim. My name is...
You talk strangely.
I'm asking your name, lady. Or girl, woman, person.
Mira.
Is that Spanish? I don't know what to ask someone from another planet, okay? This is new. I thought I'd start with something basic, but apparently you guys haven't worked all that out yet. That's cool. It's only been 40 years. No hurry.
You talk very strangely.
Jim, is it me?
You're doing great, kid. Now here, when you wrangle the direct access, here's the thing to upload for broadcast. It's something I pieced together from distress calls I've been finding.
Sort of a we're all gonna die, stay away, whatever you do kind of thing?
That's the gist. Nevik didn't want to come back here at all till Braddock twisted their arm. We need to make sure it's too expensive to try a third time. If there's one thing we know Nevik will respect, it's their bottom line. And then we need to kill this channel before Eisenberg can tell them all about Nushi. They hear about a mother load of pure T energy and they'll be back no matter what. Mira, all set with the explosives?
Yes. I've identified the critical supports in the structure. Should bring it right down.
Damn it, they're here. It wasn't supposed to be guarded.
Oh shit, dude.
Power offline.
They cut the power. We're stuck.
Then I'll get us unstuck. Take cover and sit tight. Just remember what they did to Bonnie.
I don't even know if I'm going the right way.
System malfunction. Rebooting system. System online and ready.
Gale, Mira, reactivating the tram now.
Affirmative. I think you're supposed to say Roger. Jim does affirmative work too?
Just get up here.
Wow, grouchy. You'd think he just declared war on an interplanetary corporation. Wait, is this still on?
Jim, I threw him over the railing. He was not required, was he?
That's funny. I like jokes about killing me. Cool. I'm nervous. Are you guys nervous? God, I'm annoying at this altitude.
Take him to the relay station. Once you unlock the tram gate and retrieve your rig, I will descend on foot and cover our flank.
All right, just stay in touch and don't go too far. I want you close when it's time to plant the explosives.
Jim, we can do this, right?
Don't you worry.
girl.
Yeah, I had a hunch you might think so.
She got a boyfriend, you think? She's probably got a boyfriend.
Gail?
Yeah?
Maybe not the time.
Right, right. Focus. Okay, you're gonna need to grab your rig and orient the satellite dish.
Are turning up in numbers. I'm falling back.
Okay, so I'm gonna take that as my cue to hurry the hell up. Come on! Get out, stupid loading screen! Okay, hacking into the system. I haven't done this in a while, so bear with me. They're still using NevOS 9.2, which is super easy to backdoor. Just hold tight out there, make sure nobody sneaks up on me.
They are calling the tram back. We may have to find another way down. I am working my way back up to you.
Are we looking, Gail?
Dude, I just got here. I need a little time.
Jim, Nevik cruiser inbound. Think they brought their whole army to stop us. Wait, it is passing us. Do you see it? Where could they be going? Jim, the tram is coming back up to you. Prepare yourself.
Jim Fedor, this is Ron Outlaw. In the name of Nevik, you are hereby ordered to stand down.
And return to base in my custody.
Roche, you don't need to be getting mixed up in this.
Save it, Fedor. Colonel Eisenberg told us all about what you are up to. Collaborating with a faction of snow pirates.
To sabotage our mission and
steal the T-Energy for yourself.
You believe that?
Don't try to deny it. We already found your friends. Their encampment is
under siege as we speak.
The cruiser. It's headed for our home.
It's all right, Mira. Go.
For what it's worth, this upload is working, I think. But without Mira, how do we blow things up?
Maybe looking at a change in priorities.
Roche, I have no beef with you. We don't have to do this.
I've seen you with my own eyes. Your secret meetings in the wilderness with them.
Braddock may not see you for what you are, but I do. Who do you think called Nevik down here, huh?
You... Roche, you dumb son of a bitch.
Enough!
After I cut your rig to scrap.
Remember, you brought this on yourself.
Come on, Fedon. Don't make this any harder on yourself.
Open your eyes, LaRoche. They're playing you.
If you had nothing to hide, you'd surrender already.
Gail, where's his main generator?
Okay, on the 286s, it's behind his right clavicle. Go after his right shoulder!
Thank you.
you are.
I don't know what to say, man. You got issues.
Pointless. You think I'm stupid? I'll just reroute power from my backup generator. Good news. He is stupid. I saw how he routed the backup feed months ago. His trochanter hydraulics are way vulnerable to damage now.
Really what you're concerned with right now? Seriously?
I don't know why you hijacked me and made me help you, but I know you're not a killer, so just...
Good thinking, kid.
Just go help out your new friends, and let us go, all right? Do you hear me?
Come on, Macho Man. Let's call Braddock and get you home.
And that's how Gale bought himself a reprieve. But the Forgotten back at the camp, well, they weren't so lucky.